How much a man earns is as important as options. Option A, when does he do so? B, how does he do it? C, where does he earn? D, why does he earn a fall? E, how well he spends it. Okay, so the clue being here, how much a man earns, right, is as important as what are the means by which he earns it, right? That's the more colloquial expression, right? It doesn't matter how much you earn, it depends on what is the nature of the job, right? So having said that, the right option here for us is how does he do it? Option B, right? How much a man earns is as important as how does he do it? Meaning, the means by which he makes his earnings. Right? It's that important. So, I can earn like 1 lakh per month or maybe more than that. But how am I doing it? Right? Am I doing it the right way? Am I earning it in the right manner? Or am I involved in some illegal, unlawful activities and then making that kind of a money? Right? So, what's important is not just how much he earns, but the means by which he earns it. Right? What does he do to get that money? Not where, not when, not why, or not how he spends. How he spends also can be a secondary, but the most important thing is the means by which he earns it. Because the focus here is the earning itself. Right? So one of you must help me and dash. And the options are shan't you, wouldn't you, won't you, mustn't you. So as soon as you see it, you know this is a question tag. Right? So the best thing about question tags is, especially when it comes to modals, it's very easy for you to quickly identify the option, right? The same modal is kind of replicated in the tag as well. So here we know the modal is must. So the only option that gives us with must is D, mustn't you. That's it. Right?
He's so lazy that he dash. So again, our clue phrase is so lazy, right? And see the construction already, so that. We used this in one of our earlier questions, but let's look at our options. Always extends help to others to complete their work. We can definitely rule this out. If he's lazy, he's not going to extend help. Dislikes to postpone the work that he undertakes to do. Someone who's lazy will obviously end up postponing. Out. Can seldom complete his work on time. So seldom, we already saw the meaning is rarely, hardly, right? This seems like our answer option, right? But let's look at D and E. Can't delay the schedule of completing the work. Obviously, if he's lazy, he'll definitely end up delaying it. So option D is ruled out. Can't depend on others for getting his work done. He's so lazy that he'll probably depend on others, right? He'll probably kind of try and delegate the work or get some bakra to finish his work for him. So obviously, can't be E. So our answer is option C. Right? He is so lazy that he can seldom or hardly or rarely complete his work on time. Whichever way you approach the problem, let's look at our options. No one will not solve it. Grammatically incorrect construction. Whichever way you approach the problem, right? So either there should be reference to this person or the problem. So neither is there. And it brings in another person saying no one will not solve it. Option A is ruled out. Option B, it will not be solved again. Solve is not in the right verb form, right? I need D, solved. So option B is out. It will not solve, again, not in the right construction. It will not be solved. Whichever way you approach the problem, right, that being referred to it, it will not be solved, right construction. Option D is our answer. When I met her last year, dash, options are she had married since 5 years, she had been married for 5 years, she was married 5 years ago, she had been married since 5 years. So again, we're looking at two actions in the past, right? One is this person met this person last year, and then we're talking about 5 years back or 5 years ago, this person had been married. So in terms of the construction, we need a past perfect tense, okay? right? Option A gives us the past perfect tense, but then I have since 5 years, which is incorrect because we're talking about a period of time and the right preposition we need is for, right? So we can rule out A. Had been married for 5 years, past perfect tense and for 5 years. Seems like our answer, but let's look at option C and D quickly. She was married 5 years ago. It's in the simple past tense here, but yes, there are sentences where you can have two or three verbs aligning itself with the same tense. True, but here consciously we are talking about two actions where one action happened some time back and then there is another action, right? So the action that happened first always becomes the past perfect tense. First action, had been married 5 years ago. Right? And then the simple past. So you need to look at the context carefully and then decide what tense we need, right? Simple past meant last year, right? So this is the second action. So you can rule out option C. She had been married again since 5 years, not the right construction with the preposition since. So our answer is option B. When I met her last year, she had been married for 5 years.